Scotland just a week ago, third match as captain, and his 63rd international for his country. Teams impatient as ever to start. Awaiting now the arrival of Lord Westwood, Vice President of the Football Association. Jock Steen, a few words with the Wembley officials. And he's also talking there to Bill Taylor, the Scottish coach of the England side. Bill Taylor, by the way, who's applied for the Derby County job, where he's seeking to move into management, having recently been the Manchester City coach. Jock Steen, who revels in this atmosphere here at Wembley, but this is his first international match at Wembley as manager. So Lord Westwood introduced to the Scottish players by Kenny Dalglish, Graham Souness at the end of the line, then Frankie Gray of Leeds United, Gordon McQueen, Manchester United, here 2 weeks ago in the FA Cup final, Paul Hegarty from Dundee United. That's Vic Georgie Wood of Everton and George Burley of Ipswich Town. Arthur Graham of Leeds. Joe Jordan, Manchester United. John Walk of Ipswich. Asa Hartford, Manchester City. Final word from Lord Westwood. Who served football so well, both on the Football Association and the Football League. Former chairman, of course, of Newcastle United, with him is Sir Harold Thompson, who's chairman of the Football Association. Kevin Keegan, now with Hamburg, introduces his former clubmate from Liverpool, Ray Clements, that's Bob Latchford of Everton. Moving along the line, David Watson and Mick Mills of Ipswich. And the crowd of officials just obscuring the players who go along the line. Peter Barnes, just beyond Mick Mills, then slightly hidden, I'm not quite sure who that is, the curly hair of Phil Thompson, known in the Liverpool dressing room as Snoz. Just beyond Phil Thompson, hidden is Stevie Coppell, then Trevor Brooking, and finally the Portuguese match officials. So Kevin Keegan comes back to the head of the England team as we await the playing of the national anthem. And in every sense, well, this is almost like England having to play at Hampden Park. A check on the England side, and this is currently accepted as Ron Greenwood's number one lineup. This Greenwood's 16th international as manager. He's only lost one, and England, of course, are the reigning British champions. There are three Liverpool players on the side, two Manchester City players, and then one from Ipswich, one from Chelsea, one from Manchester United, one from Everton, one from West Ham, and Kevin Keegan, the captain from Hamburg. Eight clubs represented, and between them, these players hold some 265 caps. Well, now moving to the Scottish side, there's less experience in their team. The Scottish 11, they've got 194 caps between them, And Jock Stein freely admits he is experimenting. And his biggest job is to educate the Scottish fans to the fact that he believes the England-Scotland match is not as important as winning European and world honours. And of course he is preparing, like Ron Greenwood, for matches to come still later in this season in the European Championship. Trevor Brooking, a calculated risk by the England manager to see if he's fit. He hasn't played for West Ham for 9 weeks, but came on for the last 15 minutes in the goalless draw against Wales on Wednesday. Bob Latchford, well, traditional English centre-forward who's not been in his best form for England recently, but he must remember that in his 9 international matches, he has scored 6 goals. Mick Mills, captain of Ipswich Town, last year's FA Cup winners. And on the other side, we've got his young clubmate, John Walk, playing for Scotland. An interesting story about the two. John Walk last year for the Scottish match was not in the Scottish squad. Mick Mills was playing for England in that match. And to give his young clubmate a taste of the hallowed Hampden Park turf and atmosphere, he sneaked him onto the ground where the teams walked the pitch before the match to give John Walk the feeling of Hampden. And here, 12 months later, John Walk not only played at Hampden last Wednesday, having been introduced there by his English club captain 12 months ago, but he's also now on the Wembley pitch for the second time in his career. He was here 2 years ago with Ipswich Town in the Cup Final. The two captains, Kevin Keegan of England, European Footballer of the Year, Kenny Dalglish of Scotland, the English Football Writers Player of the Year. Kevin Keegan, England's third captain in a week. Mick Mills started the series last week against Northern Ireland with a win against them in Belfast, 2-0. Then Emlyn Hughes took over in midweek. He's the recognised England squad captain, but on the bench today. And now Keegan comes in as captain for this third match in the home series. Graham Souness, so important to Scotland in midfield. And the Scots looking to Souness to do what Jim Baxter did for them at Wembley in midfield some 10, 12 seasons ago, back in 1967. Well, Jock Stein said to me on Wednesday night as he looked round the packed English crowd, where do all the English go when the Scots come to Wembley? And the question remains unanswered because I can hardly see an English flag. The whole pitch surrounded by Scottish flags and Scottish supporters. Referee Garrido of Portugal checks the watch. And England kick off. England, if they win today, take the British Championship. Scotland need to win by 6 goals to win the Championship. And Frank Bray immediately penalised by a referee who clearly is going to stamp on any sort of physical contact. It's not fact that for this British Championship, the England-Scotland match, a European referee, a referee from Central Europe, usually appointed. Paul Hegarty for Scotland. Mills, the pitch is tricky. Very heavy rain overnight and all morning. That's Burley. Jordan. Mills back to Watson, who calls to Clements. Thompson for England. Well, slotted through to Kenny Dalglish by Jordan. There's Jordan going for the return, covered by Mills. Butch Wilkins is the player who got into trouble, and he's brought back into the game by Mills, and lost a good ball. So Walker put it out of play. Butch Wilkins, it's Mills, now Watson for England. Early won it, Souness. Incidentally, the Scots have got a win by 6 clear goals to take the championship. The last time they scored more than 3 against England was on this pitch, the famous Wembley Wizards, back in 1928, where they won 5-1. Latchford to Neil. Hegarty was first. Paul Hegarty, Dundee United, the only home-based Scot in the side. It's Keegan, not by Hegarty. Flag was up for hands and Keegan penalised. Dalgleish. Oh, well not. And unfairly, apparently, by Coppell. One or two of the English supporters raising their eyebrows, but there aren't many around. Jimmy Hill alongside me thought that clearly was a fair tackle. Kenny Dalgleish and Hartford with a kick. Clearly the Scottish tactic to find Joe Jordan with his power in the air. But Jock Stein was saying to me in midweek, one of the problems with Scotland in international matches in recent seasons is that they've tried to play through Jordan's aerial ability too often. And if that doesn't work, they don't seem to have many alternatives. And I think he said to Jordan, I expect more from you on the ground. That's Neil. What a good ball and what a good run by Wilkins. Oh, he tried to lob the goalkeeper. Surely fouled by Laxford, but Ray Wilkins' run there was a bit special. The ball slotted through by Phil Neal, and he teased George Wood as he tried to chip him then. Piece of football intelligence by the Chelsea captain. Wood clearly fouled in the air by Laxford. The two Everton teammates had a joke before the match when the teams warmed up, when Laxford, as he went back to the dressing room, just put one past him for practice. Neil to Thompson. David Watson. Walk to number 8, Souness. 11 is Graham. That's Keegan tackling back. Trevor Brookie checking all forward players. And Coppell making a run, number 8. Mick Mills has gone up with the attack in the inside left channel. But the cross just not good enough. And even in these first 5 minutes, with the game so fresh, England pouring players forward from back positions. Phil Neal. Watson against Graham, and Watson too big. Walk for Scotland. Number 9, Jordan. Number 4, Thompson. Orney caught Thompson from the back. And Jordan was penalised. And the referee just having a word with Jordan. Jordan clearly made contact when Thompson had played the ball. Keegan to number 2, Neil. McQueen missed out. 8 is Coppell and 6 is Hegarty with the rescue. Now Keegan. Just a quick word from Jimmy Hill.
Well, that shot from Kevin there was identical to the other evening. On his left foot there, failed to hit the target from just outside the box. You've got to hit him well to score from there, but player of Keegan's class could do it.
Actually, one of the features that wasn't very satisfying about both England and Wales play on Wednesday night, the shooting in that match was appalling. Jordan's flick. It's Watson to Thompson. To Neal. Wilkins. Determined challenge by Kenny Dalgleish. Brookings' dummy didn't work. Souness read it, but this is Wilkins. Not often that Wilkins wastes the ball. Hegarty for Scott. It's Thompson covering Watson. And Graham quickly in. And And Mills won it from Dalglish, and Mills got a knock. And certainly, there's an aggression about this Scottish side that wasn't evident against Wales when they lost 3-0 at Ninian Park a week ago. Thompson to Watson. It's Latchford. Watson again. Barnes trying to lay it back, but Jordan got it. Now Hartford, careless ball. It's what has been called in the trade a hospital ball. And neither player really wanted it, I don't think, going in for it. Jordan. Keegan got it. That's Hartford. Bill Thompson to Watson. Barnes and Burley behind him, but Barnes found Brooking. And a foul by Ward. Brooking's ankle already sore, and this is a severe test on this difficult Wembley pitch of his fitness. It's Mills' kick. Too long. Big kick by George Wood. Watson's job to win those, and he rarely misses them. Soonest now for Scotland. Number 7, Dalglish. Linking is Frank Gray. That was Walk. Walk where he is so often for Ipswich, looking for just that sort of opportunity on the edge of the box. That's Dalglish working across the edge of the penalty area. Frank Gray up with the attack to provide the spare man. And Walk always looking for that sort of shooting opportunity. He's usually more accurate, especially with his right foot. McQueen and Latchford, neither won it cleanly. That's Burley. Hartford. Asa Hartford, who's on the list at Manchester City. Brooking. Watson. Phil Thompson. Brooking for the space. Keegan, oh, he left Hegarty so easily. Trouble could be for Scotland, but Keegan wanted to make it better. Makes the explanation to his colleagues, one or two who didn't look impressed, they wanted the ball played earlier. But it was ominous then, the way he left Hegarty so easily. Scotland sent McQueen to Mark Watson, the two centre-backs. Hegarty won it, though. It's Neil. Easily robbed by Burley, Scotland with the chance of a break. But again, it's broken down. Thompson for England. And the flag goes up rather late for Brooking offside. Jimmy Hill a bit critical of the officials.
Definitely not offside. He started his run there when the ball was played from an onside position, and the linesman just nervously raised his flag as if it was a sort of a way out of trouble.
Burley takes the kick for Scotland. Thompson again covering. He's the back player at the centre of the England defence. Watson attacking the ball, usually. Neil to Liverpool club mate Clements. Third of the Liverpool trio on the side, on the England side, Phil Thompson. This Liverpool side, well, the defence so impressive this season. A new league record, only 16 goals conceded in 42 First Division matches. Early for Scotland. Oh, Thompson and Watson for the same ball. And you can see the water splashing out there as Graham eludes Neil. Dalglish! Graham! Dalglish! Oh, and they seem to have so, so much time. They were almost spoiled for choice. Graham for Scotland. Souness. Dalglish to Souness. Space for the shot. And it goes up an England defender for a corner. And Scotland took England apart in defence then, with the England defenders having trouble on the slippy pitch. The 1-2 works, it's soon as free, it ricocheted off the defender, and that was a very important touch. So, England escape. Souness looks around at his colleagues as Dalglish takes the corner. By Butch Wilkins on the line. Goalkeeper Clements couldn't get to that. They beat the England defenders, was swerving in. A brilliantly taken corner by Dalglish, and Wilkins knocked it off the line. Souness. That was walked back to his Ipswich clubmate, Burley. Neil for England. Couple skidded, but still found Barnes. Keegan's breaking on the right. Barnes going it alone. Right through the lot with the pass. Just too long. So England survive a problem at one end and then attack Scotland at the other. That corner kick was really so good, and Clements must have had claustrophobia then from the attention given him by McQueen. He missed it completely and Wilkins knocked it away. So Wilkins for England. Fascinating start to this international. Walk for Scotland. Dalglish. Oh, and he missed out. He was so anxious to get into Gray, took his eye off the ball. Peter Barnes for England. Taking on McQueen and then choosing Neil. There's a touch there by a defender. And Latchford was almost there before goalkeeper Wood. The ball crossed. Wood went to it, but Latchford almost got there first. And this pitch could be trouble for goalkeepers because the ball is coming off the wet surface so fast. Well, 15 minutes gone and the alarm bells ringing for both defences. McQueen and Latchford. McQueen strong enough. It's Purley to number 6, Hegarty. Purley again. 8 is Souness. Walk checks on the forward players and then picks Burley. Number 10, Hartford. Oh, right through Mills' tackle. Graham. Blocked by Watson. David Watson so strong, but only found Burley. That's for Dalglish. Now Souness. Misunderstanding between the two Liverpool players. Souness expected Dalglish to try and burst through there for the 1-2. Keegan now, captain of England. Wilkins, or rather Coppell. Steve Coppell, who got the winning goal for England at Hampden Park 12 months ago. Peter Barnes, who led it on that occasion. And Wood came and missed out. Very aware that Latchford, who normally plays with him at Everton, was hunting for the ball. So Brooking, who can usually produce a selection of teasing corners, seemed to mishit that slightly. Wilkins. Flag was up for offside, and it's given. Burley. Charlie. Neil for England. Keegan. Kevin Keegan, who's really was thought to be one of England's principal strikers, coming deeper and deeper, where Bobby Charlton said before the match he didn't really want to see him too often. It's Watson to Mills. Rooking his 10, for his walk. Goal kick. John Walk, member of a big Scottish family. You may remember when he played for Ipswich in the FA Cup final 12 months ago, and lucky enough to hit the post twice, but he did go on to get a cup winner's medal. Thompson got it. Hartford for Scotland. Just a little bit difficult for some of these players to judge the pace of the through ball. And several times, what have been intended as penetrating through presses have found their way through quickly off the turf to the goalkeeper. Steegan, deep once again. Watson. Neil. Watson again. That's Gray's. Hartford. Dalglish. Gray. Souness. Dalglish into trouble. Gray. That's walk number four. And cleared by Watson, and anywhere will do. Watson, who sees the job as destructive and simple in those situations, get it away from trouble. Hegarty for Scotland. Jordan, good jump. Nobody feeding. Keegan to Mills. Challenge, a foul challenge. Jordan protested. ...20 minutes gone, no score. Thompson for England. Brookie. Barnes, support from Mills. Brookie found space well. He just got there, but he hardly got there, but the ball hit him. There was space for the cross, though. It's Keegan. Hegarty's clearance. Jordan by himself. Oh! He left Watson too easily for comfort. Now he's got number two, Neil. England with defenders streaming back. And even Jordan's power wasn't enough, but that's Graham. Apart from the possibility of offside as to whether the England defence should have cut that ball out. That, I've no doubt, will be a subject of several post-mortems both by the panel and in the press tomorrow. And Jordan brought down by Mick Mills. And this game getting fiercer. It's been competitive from the start, but the pace seems to be hotting up and the tackling is certainly getting more aggressive. The referee wants Jordan either on his feet or off the pitch. Jimmy Hill.
Well, let me make it very clear. I think Scotland deserved to be one up from the chances they had before. I'm not disputing that, but I am disputing that goal. Not so much from the offside, but Mick Mills was clearly fouled by Jordan beforehand. The player on the right, finally, wasn't interfering. The question of whether that player is offside, the scorer, is open to doubt. The one on the right not interfering, but Mills was fouled by Jordan and he stopped.
There may have been an element of memory in Mick Mills' mind then when he caught Jordan. That defense that just stopped the game when Jordan stayed down, but the referee just wouldn't let the trainer off. It's Neil. Copple's flick, stopped by Gray. Copple again. Steve Copple had a hand in both England's goals against Northern Ireland last week. Mick Mills, who was captain in that match. Watson made sure, and the whistle's gone. Free kick to Scotland. There's so much more urgency and positiveness from the Scottish side by comparison with a week ago. Souness with the chip. McQueen up there as he is so often for the set pieces. So important in defence and attack. Mills for England. Watson. Pumped at Latchford but didn't find him. Gray. Pitch not easy for defenders. Scottish supporters all feel the trip so worthwhile. But still, just under 20 minutes to go in this first half. Keegan won it. Rookie. Scotland 1-0 in front through John Wall. Copple. Easily won by Hegarty. For a nervous patch he had in the Welsh match after a mistake that led to the first Welsh goal, seems to settle down now to an international future the Scottish riders and players have been forecasting for him. Whistle's gone. Copple. Whistle's gone again. And the referee has given an indirect free kick, indicating that the foot was raised too high. Dangerous play, but there may be people in those circumstances, but dangerous play would give a penalty. Again, an interesting decision. thinking about the rule book, though. I would think the referee is right. That's Neil. That a penalty can't be awarded for dangerous play, although it is a dangerous tactic in the box, Jimmy Hill.
Yes, it is. I mean, if it were a violent tackle, then it could have been a penalty, but an unusual decision in any case, really. It's because defenders, really, when the ball's bubbling about, can't leave it lying there. They've got to have a kick at it, even if their boot does come high.
Watson missed out. That's two he's missed, with Thompson covering. Doesn't miss many in the air, usually. Oh, what a bad kick by Neil. One or two of these England defenders not too happy at all. Watson's missed one or two balls in the air. He doesn't miss all that many usually. And Phil Neal in the last few minutes has looked distinctly uncomfortable. Latchford. Rain beginning to come down once more. And we got a Scottish fan on the pitch in spite of the barricades. George Wood, the goalkeeper, wants him to get off. And he's measured his length on the pitch. And probably on his way now to see the last of the match, because surely he's not going to be allowed around the Wembley pitch much longer. And his fellow Scottish supporters making their own comments on this. George Wood appealing for him to go off. And finally, he's brought on a posse of police and leaves them rather easily. Well, there was only one ending to that. But was his journey really necessary? The really stupid part about all that is he's now seen the last of the match. A match, if you've just switched on, that Scotland are winning by one goal to nil, scored by John Waugh with 15 minutes left of the first half. Just looking for the goalkeeper, and I think I caught sight, by the way, when the fan was on the pitch and the game was held up, of the experienced international mind of manager Jock Stein at work on the bench. He was saying, calm it down, boys, just the hands down signal, calm it down and keep playing football. And certainly the Scottish side that Jock really does believe in, he says we've played better than our results, we started this match well. Watson to Thompson. Keegan. Souness. Phil Thompson. Whistle's gone again. Free kick to Scotland. Taylor, the England coach, next to the bald-headed Fred Street, Arsenal physiotherapist, and so long with the England team. Which are the subs there, the two new caps on Wednesday, Laurie Cunningham and Kenny Sampson. Leash looking anxiously back towards the free kick of Gray's. Off! And again, the ball allowed to bounce alarmingly in the England defence. Gordon McQueen. Waits for Wood. Burley. Free kick there by Burley, and there the ball allowed to bounce. And the problem created for England, really, by one of the players not really attacking the ball. Arthur Graham for Scotland. He's played on the right flank all the time, and the flag went up then as the ball was crossed. Offside given. Joe Jordan, so fearsome on the field, and his reputation a contradiction, really, of his personality off the field. The most gentle man, but really a fearsome opponent when it comes to actually playing. Thompson. Latchford, policed by McQueen. He found Copple. Hegarty missed out. Oh, that could be costly. Neil. Latchford. Pushed it too far. Neil and the goalkeeper way up the line for the challenge enough. And Wood didn't get a touch. It's a goal kick. Phil Neil just limping very slightly. Just taking a knock. But the physical presence then of big George Wood. 6 feet, 2.5. About 14 stone. Just enough to cope with the situation. Gray with his throw for Scotland. He's only got Dalglish to aim at. Well, that was good enough. Oh, and Watson just got an important touch, but he was fouled by Jordan. Just a word from Jimmy Hill about this English defence.
Well, one or two of them were unsettled. Mainly, I think, Watson and Neil. Neil was unsettled when he was caught napping by Arthur Graham to let Scotland have those two chances. Graham's pace really worried him, and it's put doubt in his mind, which I think he'll have to settle and get back to his normal game.
That was one of Graham's few excursions, because he really has, in the main, played wide on the opposite side of the field. Russell's gone, a free kick. Protest from Hegarty and smile from Keegan. Paul Hegarty, Dundee United, Scotland's Player of the Year, voted the number one by the other Scottish players. England players always looking for something different in these positions from Trevor Brooking. Brooking's kick. Easily cut out by McQueen. Oh, he only knocked back by Graham to Brooking, now Mills. Asa Hartford. Mills with the free kick. Brooking wants to take this. Plus wasn't so accurate. Hegarty got that. That was Watson hooking it back. Burley found Hartford. Good quick ball. Graham. Burley's gone charging up on the outside to help Graham. And Mick Mills, still not clear. Brooking to number six, Butch Wilkins. Asunas. Dalglish to number 10, Hartford. Mills. McQueen and Latchford, and McQueen first to recover. Off. Dalglish took a swing at that, just caught Butch Wilkins by accident into the stomach. Play waved on. It was Keegan he caught, that's Butch Wilkins. Now Copple. Wilkins, Barnes, just didn't get the touch. The flick could have been vital. Got Latchford looking for something behind him. Kevin Keegan encouraging the side. He took a nasty kick then, accidental, for the man who replaced him at Liverpool, Kenny Dalglish. Neil. McQueen looks to Wood. Jock Steen pointing to the centre of the defence. Looks if he's pointing to something and saying something to Hegarty. It's McQueen. Oh, that could have been awkward because poaching behind Watson was Graham. Now Jordan. Oh, fantastic reflex save think it may have been David Watson who got the deflection, but that could have buried England. Dalglish with the corner. Oh, McQueen got away from the markers. And again, another example of problems in the England defence.
The Scottish players, you can see McQueen runs from that position, runs away from the goal, heads back towards it, and the defenders were nowhere near him. They're showing so much aggression that they really are frightening the England defenders in the air, and we're not seeing the same sort of thing from Bob Latchford at the other end.
Hegarty won it. Rob Latchford making Jimmy Hill's point. It's Barnes to Wilkins. Now Brooking. To Keegan. England so need a goal to lift them. Neil. Copple. Neil running forward. Back to Copple. Just knocked down by Keegan, he couldn't really direct it. Well, Wembley's been such a graveyard for so many Scottish goalkeepers, and indeed goalkeepers in big matches over the years. But George Wood, playing only his second international for Scotland, seems to have settled well. Watson just touched it, now Mills. Six is Wilkins. Burley. George Burley's club manager, Bobby Robson's always rated him as an international prospect, and now he's broken through at the full level. Having been chosen previously at all international levels for Scotland. Scottish goal scored by John Walke after 21 minutes. 5 minutes to half-time. Wilkins to Neil. Latchford. Barnes. Wilkins to Barnes. Foul given. Soulis claiming, of course, that Barnes was acting. Neil for England. Eight is Copple. Ten is Brooking. Policed by Hart. Neil. Final ball. Two Wilkins, just not good enough. Trevor Brooking not really able to stamp himself on this match in the way Ron Greenwood would expect. But difficult for him, returning to senior football after a gap of, think of, about 9 weeks. Walk for Scotland. It's Jordan streaking through. Nobody touched it. Watson was in hard. Keegan, deep once more for England. Wilkins. Latchford found the space well. Poor Bob Latchford, so out of form at the moment, but persevered with by Ron Greenwood. And he has scored six goals in his last nine internationals for England. Tackling back by Keegan after Mills had got in trouble, just held up the attack. Watson just got a touch now. Hartford, well, that was Wilkins. He's only found Dalglish. England under terrible pressure again, relieved by Copple. Stevie Copple again. Keegan England forced to bring players back because of the Scottish pressure. It's Keegan. Wilkins on for Keegan. That's Wilkins. Koppel. Wilkins. Cross is very deep. Cut out by Hegarty. Watson. Well stopped by Hegarty again. It's Brooking. And offside. Flags up. The thousands and thousands of Scottish supporters clearly happy and delighted, not only with the score, but with that piece of play which was academic, and celebrating the fact that Kevin Keegan, the England captain, lost the ball anyway. Just under 2 minutes to half-time. Mills. Walks through. Thompson. Challenged by Dalglish and foul. Jockstein already on the way to the players' tunnel. Can't get back quickly enough. He's only yards away from the tunnel. Obviously, I would think, pleased with what he's seen and ready already for the half-time team talk. View almost obscured at most of the pitch by these massive guardsmen. Whistle's gone, a free kick to England. Jockstein looks such a lonely figure there, and I think very few of the Scottish supporters have recognised that he's there. Headed away, Thompson again. Harper to Jordan. Gray. And Jordan being spoken to by the referee. I doubt if Jockstein at the far end can see that, because Jordan knocked the ball away to waste time. Watts to Barnes. Wilkins. Keegan. Brooking. Good flick. Barnes behind him. Half-time whistle should go at any moment. Burley's kick. Watson. Koppel. Latchford. And the whistle has gone. And what a boost for England just before half-time. In the final minute of play in the first half, Peter Barnes, so out of form at Manchester City, scores what could be a most important goal for England and leaves them in with a chance of winning this British Championship. They must win today, but Peter Barnes put that one away. John Walk, number four, got Scotland's goal after 21 minutes. And he and Gordon McQueen share notes there. And I think clearly John Walk's attitude was, we were a little bit unlucky then, because the ball wasn't truly hit, But those are awkward for goalkeepers. They'll tell you that they truly hit what is more easy to save, and Wood must have seen it terribly late as it came through the defenders. So, Ron Greenwood and Jock Steen, both with a lot of talking to do at half-time, although I do believe that Jock Steen has more reason to be satisfied.
So, a competitive and very entertaining first half, with Scotland winning on points, but of course the match standing drawn at 1-1. A great
scene, we return to the main action of the day. Jock Steen on his way back, stunning blow really for Scotland just before half time. Scores level at 1-1, and Scotland to kick off at the start of the second half. Dalglish and Joe Jordan, the Scottish spearhead. Jordan to Dalglish. Now Graham, breaking his walk, but the ball wasn't good enough. Mills. Mick Mills so aware that his left back place is under threat from young Kenny Sampson. Burley to Ipswich clubmate Walk. Dalglish, Graham, right through Watson's tackle, and Clements needed a second grasp. Arthur Graham went straight through big David Watson then, and makes his own comment on what happened. McQueen, Wilkins, Barnes to Keegan. Latchford played into an impossible position really for him, but he was fouled anyway by McQueen. Latchford has looked to be so isolated up front without very much support from Keegan in the first half, with, as Bobby Charlton said, Keegan getting deeper and deeper. Brookie usually inventive from outside the box. George Wood isn't all that happy with what's happening at the wall. He is now. And Brookie taking a lot of time. He's got Keegan there with him. It's Keegan, the chip. The flick on by Latchford, stopped by Frank Gray. That's McQueen. Latchford, well stopped by McQueen. Now Walk. Neil. Not happy with the referee. Jordan wasn't either. And in fact, I think both thought David Watson should have been penalised, but both Jordan and Watson were high. So Watson right up with the attack, marked by Joe Jordan. Mills. Hegarty. Steve Coppell. Barnes is through. Wilkins. Keegan. Barnes. Oh, what a good tackle by Burley. He was quickly in. Is it a good match for Scotland? Watson. That's Burley once more. Neil. Wilkins. Keegan. For enormous pressure. The Scots are keeping with him. Now Graham. Beat, now he takes on Mills. pitch beating. Oh, Clements! The most astonishing mistake then. The ball pushed back by Steve Coppell, and Clements made the most incredible error. Just let the ball slip through his hands. Steve Coppell there, no pressure really for Clements, as Jordan was miles away, but goalkeeper's so aware of the presence of Joe Jordan. But clearly, it wasn't just that threat of Jordan's. He obviously didn't look at the ball, he thought he'd got so much time. Dalglish with the corner. Thompson knocked it away, and that's Thompson in again, but beaten by Souness. Defence, their back four and Ray Clements, so much the cornerstone of this side. But in no sense looking happy today. It's Gordon McQueen. Usually all on the left foot. Thompson. Mills. Neil. Good run by Wilkins into space. Broken down now, Hartford, Dalglish, looking more like the player he is for Liverpool every week. Ray to Souness, to number four, Walk. Burnley's given him a lot to do, and it's too much. But these two young Ipswich players, both stolen by the Ipswich scouts from Scotland, both came down from junior clubs, Walk and Burley, Burley two and Walk four. Growing with every game they play for Scotland. First capped a week ago, but they're looking better international players already. Now Barnes for England. Keegan. Neil. Coppell. Burley. Graham. Thompson did just enough to give Neil time. Well, Neil. Gray's throw. Hartford. Free kick. Followed by his Manchester City club mate, Peter Barnes. Both Barnes and Hartford, of course, on the City transfer list. Very much in the shop window this afternoon. Gray's kick. Neil's header. Now Jordan. Thompson. Frank Gray's throw. Jordan with space. Tackle by Thompson, just delayed the attack. Souness into space for the cross. Mishit it. Wilkins. Gray's throw. Hartford. Asa Hartford, known as Ace to his clubmates. It's Frank Gray. Hartford again. The cross wasn't better, but again the ease with which he beat the fullback didn't promise much for England. Difficult pitch to turn on though for defenders. Ball breaking 50-50 to Keegan. Walk. Graham and Mills. Actually, Arthur Graham just trotting down in front of McMills. that's played an important part for Scotland. I know that Jock Stein, when he was manager of Leeds, admired him so much. Mills was appealing then, and the whistle has gone. Jock Stein admired him so much at Leeds, he's lost no opportunity to bring him into the Scottish side. And that is true of Frank Gray as well, the number three. Jock saw enough of him at Leeds to feel he was a future international in his position at fullback. And today he's won his sixth cap for Scotland. Hegan. Twisting and turning. Neil. Goal kick. Really compelling situation in the British Championship, because remember, if the scores remain level, Wales take the title for the first time outright since 1937. So the Welsh players have played so well in the British Championship this year, more than interested spectators, and their manager too, Mike Smith, wherever they may be. I suspect some may be at Wembley and some at home. It. Brooking. Copple breaking on the right. Pitch so treacherous. Jordan to Hartford. Good ball to Gray. Watson. He had to make that is because he didn't want it flashing around in front of the goal. Kenny Dalglish, who had Watson under pressure. But a good break by Gray on the left. Box is packed with players. McQueen haunting Clements on the goal line. McQueen number five. So big, so dominating in the air. Threat to any defender. Dalglish's corner. McQueen was there, but he was beaten by Watson. This is Keegan. Wilkins played into trouble. Clash between Wilkins and Souness, they collided. It was a 50-50 ball. England on with it. Wilkins. Neil. Thompson. Neil's gone wide. Won by Hegarty. Now Thompson again. Was blocked by Halford. Neil. Burley's head. George Burley, such a polished player in defence. He looks so young, but he's played well over 200 league matches for Ipswich. Brought into the side while 17-year-old. Taking the near post. It's Barnes. Hartford's header. Neil, trying to consider what he's going to do. It's Cottle, a misunderstanding with Mills. Bench, and one or two of the subs there will be wondering whether their opportunity will come. Ray for Scotland. Dalglish 7, Thompson 4. Wilkins. Latchford. To Brooking. Latchford did well then. Barnes. Seeking to attack the back. Oh, he threaded his way through. And he's such a tantalising dribbler. It all seems so tentative. And the decision is a bad one by the referee, because that was clearly a corner. It all looks so tentative, this dribbling, but he just wriggles his way through, and the ball was certainly deflected by a Scottish defender. Really tantalises defenders, though, when he attacks them like that. And the England appeal was justified, but the referee misplaced, really, to make a judgment. Jordan won it. It's Hartford. Mills and Walk. And that eluded Clement. congratulation from Clements. That's Waugh. It eluded Clements completely, and Watson settled for what was clearly right, safety. John Waugh injured in the process. And being asked to leave the pitch, he's just rolled off the pitch. The Argentinian linesman's in position for the corner. And walks back on. Clearly got the incentive to get back there as Dalglish takes the corner. Oh, McQueen and Watson clashed there, and Watson got a knock in the back. Two giants in the air. Harford with help from Souness. Now Gray. Ball was flicked on by Hegarty. It's Neil. Not much left. Good flick by Latchford. Barnes looking to feed off it, was just too far. Watson and Jordan. Barnes. As always, risking that tackle from the back of Burley. I think he knew it was coming as well. Half an hour left for play. The score's level, and the championship, if the scores stay level, belongs to Wales. Scotland got to win by 6 clear goals to take the title. England just need a win. So we've still got 3 countries theoretically in with a chance in the British Championship of taking the title. Now Watson back. Hegarty. He's looked such a better player today. Got the security of McQueen alongside him. Was vastly the most experienced Scottish player in the back five, taking in the goalkeeper. And in fact, McQueen is the only player of that back five who's in double figure in caps. So Jockstein really placing an awful lot of reliance on McQueen alongside Hegarty to guide the Dundee United player through this really testing international. Barnes. Wilkins. Thompson is free. It's all too tight. Jordan for Scotland. Souness to number 11, Graham. On the list at Manchester City. Solid defender. Burley's kick. Won by Thompson. Now Graham. He's pushed it too far. Robbed by Keegan. That's Souness. Couple looking for the quick break. Keegan on for Latchford. He's very, very wide. He might have made the angle better. Support behind him now from Barnes. Number 11. He's found Mills. Push wide. Wilkins. And it came off board and sent the net from Coppell. And England have stolen another. Emily Hughes, captain of the squad, leads the celebrations. And Wilkins' shot wasn't held by goalkeeper Wood. And once again, a goalkeeping error put Scotland in trouble in yet another Wembley International. Mills to Wilkins. The shot was powered. It wasn't held. Two England players looking for it. And Coppell knocked it in. He got the winner against Scotland 12 months ago. But Wilkins' shot was too powerful for the goalkeeper. And England lead 2-1. Well, Coppell had a hand in both goals against Northern Ireland last week. He won the match against Scotland 12 months ago. And he may well have done just that again today. But these Scottish supporters quick to respond. They're raising their voices again, trying to lift the team. And it must be said, Scotland hardly deserved to be behind. But England lead. Check on the time, 18 minutes of the second half gone. Dalglish to number two, Burley. Dalglish. Beginning to look more and more confident as the match goes on. He's been a lonely figure a lot of the time up front for England. England really played their way through what's not been an easy patch for them, and now in front. Mills. Offside. By the highest goalkeeping standards, the one or two accusing eyes will be looking at George Wood, because no matter how hard the shot is, when you get your body behind it at international level or any level really, a goalkeeper is expected to hold the ball. And indeed, I think George Wood, who would have been first choice for Scotland by many of the English first division goalkeepers for some time now, may count himself a little bit unlucky, but will also feel probably that he ought to have held that. Still, they don't all stick, and Scotland have paid the price. Brookie now. Neil. There, but that seems to fight for, but Wood's confidence hasn't evaporated, obviously. He handled that ball, which is so greasy, with supreme confidence. Well, England suddenly with time to spare. Neil Brooking just dummied McQueen and was fouled. Wilkins. It's Barnes, he found Keegan. And Keegan's left foot not accurate enough. Chances seem to be falling this week to Keegan on his weaker side, his left foot. The ball ricocheted back on Barnes rather than was played there. It stuck with Keegan, and the shooting opportunity so clearly on. And Jordan missed out. Thompson cleaned it up. Thompson again. And a player offside. Arthur Graham just looking around, was just caught offside. We're exactly halfway through the second half here at Wembley, and England lead Scotland by 2-1. Walk could only deflect it to Latchford, that's Keegan. And McQueen and Burley in a misunderstanding. Brookings come up to take the corner. Watson's been pushed forward. Mick Mills is sent into the 6-yard box. Brooking. Watson. He really is such a magnificent header of the ball. He's so powerful when he gets up and so difficult to move. Thank you. Watson's header. Hartford. Gray. Hartford. Broke down thanks to Steve Coppell's persistence. Keegan. Rookie breaking forward. Took the attention away from Keegan. There's the 1-2. And it's 3-1. And the Scots defence sliced the bar. George Wood buries his face in the Wembley turf in anguish. But he was left with nothing he could possibly do as the defence parted. There's Keegan. The 1-2 with Brooking, the man he employed George playing with so well. Perfectly played at the right pace by Brooking. And Scotland hadn't got a hope. Marvellous example of understanding. And Keegan through to make it 3-1. 69 minutes gone. And suddenly, England from trailing 1-0, 3-1 in front. And as the seconds tick on, they're looking more and more confident. No matter how they play, have this marvellous habit under Ron Greenwood of refusing to be beaten. In fact, this is their 16th international under the Greenwood management, and so far, they've only lost once. Still, the match by no means over yet. About 20 minutes left for play. Emily Dews, the England squad captain, nothing he likes better than beating Scotland. And in fact, to that extent, he says, I'm like the Scots. They decide that the England match is the most important in their calendar, and to some extent, that's true of me for England. Hartford. Mills. Haggerty. And I wonder how long it is since England lost a two-goal lead. I remember Alf Ramsey in Lyon, when West Germany put England out of the World Cup, saying that he couldn't remember an England side losing a two-goal lead as they did there. Well, England 2 goals in front today against Scotland. And I really can't think, or it may have happened, that England have lost a two-goal lead against anybody in the years intervening. Jock Steen with a lot to think about now. His side hasn't done a lot wrong, except in defence, where they've really been punished for errors, and the defence really slid right down the centre with that 1-2 from Keegan for the third goal. With Keegan and Brooking. Whistle's gone. Paul Hegarty with a problem. Referee is determined not to let trainers on the field. Rido of Portugal, he's having a look for himself, which gives a chance for Jimmy Hill to give his assessment.
Well, one can't help feeling sorry for Scotland, but on the other hand, full credit to the England team, because they'd taken a real mauling in the first half, but they came back with putting a lot of men forward. And there's no doubt that the goals that they got were a result of living dangerously. It left the game open for Scotland to break, and you get in front again. But there's, for me, it showed a lot of courage for the England players to do that kind of thing on what for some of them must be an off day. I think Kevin Keegan, I remember on Wednesday night when he came up after the Wales game, he was saying how tired he was feeling. And there's no doubt that 2 games in 4 days on this stamina-sapping Wembley pitch is a lot for any player to take. He hasn't been at his best, but my goodness, he showed us a touch of his best then when he, got under that pass and made the goal. But here we go again now with David.
Hartford's kick. David Watson being encouraged by Mick Mills. It's been a hard, hard game out there. Not just the conditions, but the physical contact as well. Trouble this season has got a knock, and Ron Greenwood so aware of it. Oh, Walk stole that one from Mick Mills. Graham, number 11, the angle difficult. times, claimed it really well. Ball with Brooking. Mills. Wilkins missed it, but Barnes was behind him. And two England players making a mess of that. Souness, Dalglish, Hartman, Jordan. Still in play. George Jordan really battling away. Hartford. Gray. Jordan again. Gray. Jimmy Hill.
Just seen the England defenders are standing up much better in this half. You notice here that Scotland had the ball in their area, but they didn't panic. They just kept covering and marking, whereas in the first half at times, they were going in and trying to rob them and leaving themselves beaten.
Fifteen minutes to go, 3-1 to England. And it's Keegan to Thompson. David Watson, who seems to be limping very slightly. He was on Wednesday night against Wales. Graham. Burnley's going to help on the outside. Good run by the fullback. He was inviting the pass. Thompson. And I would think Burnley's in this Scottish side to stay. He's gone. It's not wide by Hegarty. Alvish is always threatening with these corners, very accurate with them. This Dalglish is 63rd international, a record number of caps for Scotland. Queen. The luxury for once of time. And Burley. Souness. Almost won by Watson. Barnes easily found Souness. Watson again. Wilkins didn't lay it properly. Of whistling going on around the ground. I think some of the Scottish supporters are getting a bit restless and wondering whether Jockstein will think of making a change, bringing on a sub. No sign now of any subs warming up from either side. Hartford, he did well to get through that lot. Jordan to Souness. Ray to Hartford. Playing their way out of trouble. Working a neat little box. Hegarty. Kenny Dalglish. Walked. So often so dangerous from there. But so far, not today.
As Ray Clements gets the ball there and Jockstein reflects ruefully on how this game against Scotland has gone against Scotland, you can think really of the difference between perhaps the keepers on today's game. We talked about England being superior in that department, and if you think about it, it's that that's turned the game.
George Wood from Everton. And on the other side of the city, Ray Clements from Liverpool. One today for England and the other for Scotland. Keegan. Queen placing him very firm in the tackle. Brooking. Latford to Brooking. There's something here. Very wide now, though. The possibilities were there momentarily for England. Neil. Bob Latchford, very much the traditional English centre forward, most unsophisticated in many ways at international level. But the signs are there that Bob Latchford is beginning to get confidence back after a really bad spell, both at club and England level. Hartman. Watson. Burley. Scots fans, loyal as ever. Unquenchable optimism, but they're 3-1 down. Hartford. Thompson, they only found walk. Graham. Well, Arthur Graham prepared to try things. Hegarty, Wilkins for England. Latchford to Wilkins. Couple. Thompson. Knocked into space, but Hartford filled it. To Hegarty. This is Jordan. What a battler he's been for Scotland today. 3-1 tackle, but not the second. Neil covering Thompson very effectively. Wilkins. Scotland keeping the England players under pressure, and now Jordan's offside. Pity it broke down there, because the Scottish players have worked so hard to win the ball. And Hegarty wins once more. Souness. He gets brushed aside. Having lost the ball the first time, he gets back to have a go for it. Oh, Hartman. Oh, what a good run by Dalglish. And Clements way, way outside the penalty area. The last man left to deal as a sweeper with Dalglish's burst through. But momentarily, England were caught square then. And Dalglish was quick enough to break through, but Clements so quick to react. Watson in the way, getting out Hartford's cross. Thompson. Dalglish got a bad knock there from his Liverpool club colleague, Clements, but it was inevitable as Clements came out. Koppel looks for help. Wilkins, rather. Now Keegan. Wilkins in trouble. It was too easily read by Walker, who's now found Graham. And Scotland with a spare man here, but Dalglish is limping. He can't get through there. And Barnes taking some responsibility in defence. But Dalglish was the spare man then, and Dalglish reduced to a limp by that tackle. Fair as it was, and inevitable as it was, by Ray Clements, the England goalkeeper, just outside the penalty area. He was left as last man. He was bold enough and quick enough to get. Keegan for England. to Brookie. Tried to bend it, but Wood saw what was possible. Wilkins for England, now a couple outside. And England really begin to open up this defence. Barnes! Hegarty was right in with him. Frank Gray for Scotland. Dalglish looks to be moving slightly better now. Mills, it's a very ambitious ball by Dalglish. Watson, and Trevor Brooking. His first match for so long, he's lasted quite well. Really was on the pitch as a test for the European Championship match on Wednesday week against Bulgaria, and he appears to have come through it reasonably and without trouble. Latchford prepared now with growing confidence to take on McQueen. It didn't work, but it's a sign of the times that Bob Latchford is trying things on. This side all the time. His enthusiasm is so infectious, Kevin Keegan. So Brooking with a corner. Latchford. Interesting to see what Jimmy Hill thinks about Latchford's apparent rejuvenation.
Well, like all the England players, of course, he's a different player now that they're in the lead, and he is trying one or two things, as David says, but I just feel that England team lacks one player of extreme pace up front. They are in no position to play a through ball to Latchford, really, Barnes or any of the others, and I'd love to see one really athletic runner get in there who's got extra pace.
And that label may be placed on either Tony Woodcock at Nottingham Forest or Trevor Francis in the match against Bulgaria. The very interesting... retains faith with Latchford, or whether he puts in somebody who's a little bit sharper like Woodcock or Francis. And certainly the next 10 days or so, there'll be a great deal of speculation towards that end. Flag was up, throw to be retaken. George Burley, number two. That the Scottish international team is the luckiest team in the world, because win or lose, the supporters stay with them and really do back the team all the way. Here we are, 3 minutes to go in the international. Scotland losing by 3-1, and they're still encouraging the players. It's Graham. Hegarty. Oh, and Latchford brushed him off. Latchford's real power counted. He's got McQueen to take on now, to Barnes, to Latchford, and the block by McQueen. It's Dalglish. A lot of these players are no wonder looking tired. It's been a hard match out there, physically demanding, and they've certainly earned their match fees. Walk. It's Dalglish moving with a bit more freedom. Can't Hartford well. Watson. Good ball to Wilkins. Keegan's gone wide on the right. Tremendous shot from Steve Coppell. Caught his foot as the tackle went in. Jordan and Neil. activity on the bench now. They're all looking at watches. Bill Taylor there is applied to the Derby County job as manager. Just pull the sleeve of his tracksuit back, checking up on everyone, and I make it on my watch that we're now entering the last minute of the game. As soon as now to Burnley. Soonest. Hegarty. Sign of tiredness then. But Paul Hegarty has no reason to be displeased with his first week in international football. It didn't start too well against Wales, but it's got better and better. Keegan. Wilkins. Brookie. Oh, he was well robbed by Walk. It's Graham to Dalglish. Soonest. Burley. Kenny Dalglish checking up what's on. Hartford. It's Graham to Burley. Soonest. Jordan. Nothing's lost for Joe Jordan. Typical of the fight that one sees in almost any Scottish side. John Walk knew a week ago to international football, got the Scotland's goal today. Whistle, and England retain the British Championship, beating Scotland by 3-1. Scotland scored first through Walk. The English girls, Peter Barnes, put them on the way. We had a better display in the second half from England than in the first, when Scotland were so unlucky, really, to be only on level terms. And goals, two in the space of 7 minutes, from Koppel and Kevin Keegan. Keegan's possibly the best of the match, as he worked his way through with Brooking. The two captains, Keegan and Dalglish, congratulate each other and swap shirts, and the Scottish fans stand to salute what was a promising English Scottish performance. I must say that both managers will have reason to be pleased with this. Ron Greenwin for England's durability and their ability to take chances, and Jock Stein, because Scotland have got together a side here that promises a great deal. He began to experiment a week ago, it was forced upon him, but there must have been a lot he's seen at Wembley today that must have pleased him. This, a really full-blooded international, entertaining for the crowd. Graham Souness, the two goalkeepers, this union of back men formed, coming off together, Ray Clements and George Wood. Perhaps George Wood, little unlucky and counted responsible for the second goal. Nothing he could do about the third at all. So now a check on the British Championship table with England.